cultural heritage. What have you been able to do, sir, to promote this as a monastery venture?
Well, let me first of all thank you for recognizing our rich cultural heritage. But invariably, there's hardly any part of Nigeria that does not have rich cultural heritage. Now, what we do about it is that entirely. For us, culture is related to development. And I have said that when you talk of cultural heritage, invariably you're talking about how people used to live. You're talking about the value system. You're talking about things that they hold dear to themselves. We are talking about their response to their environment over time. That is why in people's culture, you can actually discern the progression in their level of civilization. We have had an misfortune of going through colonialism in Africa. And you know what it does to the mind. It eventually cages your mind. It was a deliberate policy of the colonial masters to make you forget your past, because if you don't really know where you're coming from, you cannot appreciate where you should be. So it's part of the post-colonial mentality. It's a slavish mentality. It's not a can-do mentality. It's not a mentality that propels you to want to be the best globally. And we believe that for us to be able to recreate the type of psyche that will drive development, we must look back at our rich cultural heritage. We must look back and see what we used to do right, and see how we can leverage on it. We are not inventing the wheel, but we can leverage on our heritage to actually want free our mind, to let our people know that in terms of human endeavor, in many aspects, they were actually progressing along the tangent of development, and that there's nothing inherently wrong mentally with us. There's nothing that says we cannot get to that level. This is how we see culture. This is why we talk about the organic linkage between our cultural heritage and our developmental endeavors. And that's why we're investing in culture. Apart from the short-term, medium-term money spinning part of it, we also think that it is good to free the mind of our people, to let them see that even century past in our traditional village settings, people don't sleep with fecal matters. People had ways of disposing of their waste. People had the artistic elegance of Italian life to produce something as colorful and vibrant as this. This is where, and you look at culture, what are people used to do, you can see the working of the mind as at that time. I think it gives the confidence that we can capture the world, we can be what we want to be. It frees our psyche, and it is only a free psyche that can drive development. So for us, like I said, it's money spinning culture. In the last 2 years, we thank God what we have been. We can place emphasis on our cultural heritage, cultural development. For the first time in the history of this state, we came second at the Abuja Carnival. We have represented the Abuja Carnival in South Africa. Very, very commendable outcome. So for us, we will continue to invest in culture. We continue to do what we have to do to bring back inner pride of our people.
Yeah. So 2 years ago, we heard a lot about Mardi Festival in Dubai. There seems to be a low tide now.
A low tide. Mardi is leveraging on geographic love, leveraging on nature's free gift. There are not too many places like Inari. It's the ancient city completely surrounded by very exotic hills. And we thought we should draw the attention of the world to this very exotic outcrop of hills. And we thought the best way to do it is to package an international mountain climbing competition with a cultural fiesta. We have had two editions. First edition 2009, second edition 2010. And we're going to have the 2011 edition. We hope that the 2011 edition will even be better in elegance and in participation. So there's not, this is low season, but the high season for Mari is December, when the festival actually takes place. And we have had, the whole idea is to focus all the attention on what we have. Of course, this has multiplied effect on the local economy, and we will continue.
Okay, sir, apart from knowledge, there are some other natural endowments still that we call for tourist attractions. And we have the Bobo Lake, we have many others.
Yeah, there are so many of them, and like our strategy is to start with one, then gradually expand our commitment. Because you must also know that promoting tourism is not, could be very expensive. There's a lot of bulk initial investment. So we'll start with Nari. And there are other very, very rich cultural things that we want to exhibit to the world. Like now the Google Festival is going on in Owo. The costume, the Saturia elegance, it's something that we also want to see. We take them one at a time so that we don't get congested. Because you also know that a lot of areas are competing for limited resources. So we are not unmindful of what other areas. But ultimately, we are also encouraging private entrepreneurs to come and invest in tourism here. And with government, with private entrepreneurs, we can actually make Kondo State one of Nigeria's preferred tourism destinations.
Now, yeah, talking about private investments in the tourism side, there was this chance involvement in the promotion of Adil Fagua's works. I think we had one there last year. There was this impression that the state government is going to sponsor the second edition this year. We have not heard about that.
It is supposed to be a partnership between CHAMS and the Kondo State government. We have indicated our interest, and we are waiting for CHAMS to get to fix a date. We have said it clearly that we're ready to partner. One, because the Ofagwa was a citizen of the state, he lived in the state, and we're very proud of him. In a way, there seems to have not been anybody in African Yoruba literature up to now that can match the record of Fagwa. For CHAMS to have got the right to produce all of this, we feel natural partner with CHAMS to be able to move this forward. And, our commitment remains the same. We are ready to continue to partner with CHAMS in promoting the literature of the Ofagwa.
On sports, sir, Sunshine Stars is doing a lot. Has gone a lot.
We can say, I don't want to sound boastful. We are the number one football state in Nigeria today. Empirically, Sunshine Star, which is in the Premier League, as I speak with you now, we are topping the table, Premier League. Sunshine Star is getting into the semi final of CAF Cup. Our Rising Stars has moved from Pro League to Premier League. So we'll be playing in Premier League next year. We will have two teams in the Premier League. And at the grace of God, we hope Sunshine will win the CAF Cup. And they go on to play the champion compete and win it, I will be an unprecedented double this state. The Sunshine Queens, as I speak with you now, they're top in the table in their league, the women league, and they are also qualified for the semi-final in the Champions League of the women Champions League. So we have three teams, only 1 year doing excellently well. It's unprecedented in the history of this state. And at the end of this season, we will probably have recorded an unprecedented record in the history of football in Nigeria. I'm very pleased and I feel happy about this. I think God has been good to us. Again, when we came on board, we said we will target two specific areas where we have relative advantage. One, football, because it's the most popular sport event in the whole world. Then swimming, because of our coastline and all of that. And we have started seeing results. Even at the festival, before we came on board, we were 12th in the national festival. This last year, participating for the first time, I challenged the boys that they must come within the first five. They came fourth. After Rivers, the Coast, Edward Delta, he came forth. By the grace of God, the next festival we want to lead the country. So we've made very, very good showing in this sport area.
And what about other sports supports, like stadium?
Yes, you can see the massive work going on in our stadium. We completed the Olympic size swimming pool, which every government had attempted to complete way back from 76 or so. Completed it, and at the opening ceremony, we invited the national chairman of the Swimming Association, Fatai Williams, with the chairman. And he said that because of international standard was